Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the Beliefs of Islam with me, Hassan Hadi. In today's episode, we are going to talk about the existence of God in the light of the design argument from human language. As a matter of fact, there are numerous different theistic arguments which base their evidential nature upon inference from unique features of this universe, which seemingly have no other explanation other than within a supernatural design. These arguments, as have been referenced in previous episodes, are known as teleological arguments. Now, what is the definition of the teleological arguments? They simply are defined as a family of arguments which all infer from precision and design, which finds no valid explanation in anything other than a supernatural creator. Today, we shall briefly be exploring one such teleological argument, which looks at the unique nature and experience of human language and linguistic capability. Humans are distinct from all other species we have come across until now in their unique ability to develop and learn not merely one, but indeed several constructed languages, each one possessing unique features of complex stylistics and forms. Now, our argument will mainly focus upon one crucial point, namely that any naturalistic explanation of our human development of language falls fatally short of a viable, feasible explanation of the difference between human linguistic capabilities and the language skills of other animals. Now, to put this in a logical context, the argument has got the following premises. All human societies have language. They always have. Language was not invented and did not spread. Contemporary grammars are no more complex than those of hunter-gatherers, that is to say, pre-Stone Age man. Humans are proficient language users, regardless of intelligence, social status, or level of education. Children are fluent speakers of complex grammatical sentences by the age of 3, without benefit of formal instruction. Children are capable of inventing languages that are more systematic than those they hear, showing resemblances to languages that they have never heard, and obeying grammatical principles for which there is no evidence in their environments. Therefore, God does exist and endowed humans with an innate ability to acquire and use language. Now, to quote David Primack, a prominent behavioral psychologist, the dilemma of the naturalist is the following. I challenge the reader to reconstruct the scenario that would confer selective fitness or recursiveness. Language evolved. It is conjectured at a time when humans or proto-humans were hunting mastodons. Would it be of a great advantage for one of our ancestors squatting alongside the embers to be able to remark, beware of the short beast whose front hoof bob cracked when having forgotten his own spear back at camp. He got in a glancing blow with a dull spear he borrowed from Jack. Now, human language is an embarrassment for evolutionary theory because it's vastly more powerful than one can account for in terms of selective fitness. A semantic language with a simple mapping rules of a kind one might suppose a chimpanzee would have appears to confer all the advantages one normally associates with discussions of mastodon hunting or the like. For discussions of that kind, semantic classes, structure, dependent rules, recursion, and the rest are overly powerful devices, absurdly so. This is for today, until we meet next episode. Thank you very much indeed, and assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.